cheer the Pittsburgh Steelers. Tucknell and Nolte's friends are all on their beat. Go out and get them Steelers. Bradshaw and Rocky and Franco and Lee.
All right, listen up, yeah. Cupcake.
Okay.
Your teammate Jack Lambert said, why don't you put a skirt on him?
That's right. Talking about quarterbacks.
Talking about quarterbacks.
That's right.
The game is changing. It used to be a physical, violent game. You'd get ear holed. People try to knock you out.
Right.
The rules are changing. The league is changing. How physically violent was it when you played?
Well, because as the rules change, I can remember coming here, we had crack back. We could have crack back blocks, So you guy was back was turned, you could cut him anyway. That was well. It's safety then became an issue. Then obviously has become a concern over the years, and so the rule changes, and so then it has to become a scoring game. So then we got to move the ball. We got to have action. So we got to reduce some of the things we could do in the past. So penalty wise, and then physicality wise, that changes because we need to have an open game. We have excitement.
70 points a game.
That's right. We're trying. We're selling excitement to the fan base out there, and it's not so much about the game. So all those old stories, were true from a physical point of view, gouging guys in
it. Conrad Dobler. Remember Conrad Dobler?
Dobler coming across. Now, Conrad Dobler, he comes up, he's a guard, he comes up, his first move is here, into the neck, That's right.
Then he bite a ref once?
Well, he might have, he had it. But Conrad's whole theory was the fact is that I get to your throat, then I control you, because you can't move inside. So the illegal hit was here. It just happened to slip up around here.
Like that. Right, I can tell you a story about me and Dobler in a car, like a Yugo in Orlando, but I can't. Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's right.
It's a story, but I can't tell you here because it's inappropriate.
That's right.
All right, just another quick question, sir. American values. What does that mean to you?
Well, it's interesting. I mean, it's interesting being here at camp, now that you're asked, and seeing the fan base that comes here, and the families that come here, and the kids that the parents who were their age when I was coming back, when it started, when we started winning Super Bowl. But it's interesting just to hear them tell stories about their parents, about how important the Steelers were, about the values that they had handed down from generation to generation. Now they want their kids to be able to have that same experience coming up, although the experience obviously has changed. But I find it very, very satisfying. And maybe it's just because of Steeler fans, but I find it very satisfying because I don't think it's just here. And I think that value from sports cuts across the country, different teams, whatever they may be, that they, want to be a part of that success or be a part of that team. And the people that have brought joy to their lives have now become icons in their lives. And so
like a Rocky Blieler, Franco.
Like a Franco. And I hear stories about, not me, but I hear stories about other players. They met this player, they met that player,
I met Conrad Dobler and he bit me.
See? You'll never forget that.
All right, one last question. Right. Two Rocky Blieler plays. I want you to choose your favorite Rocky Blieler play. I think it's Cleveland 1980-something.
That's right.
Blieler runs about a 6'7", 40 at this
point. That's right, I think, yes.
Gets the ball at the 20-yard line, Steelers ends, and suddenly is running down the field for how far?
70 yards.
70 in Cleveland.
In Cleveland, and I scored.
You're expecting to get hit at some point, tackle.
That's right, because it was. So it was the whole thing. It was a third and one situation down on the 20-yard line. So one of the things we knew about Cleveland is that they would come up to a goal line defense in that situation. And so, and the read happened to be the middle linebacker. So we knew that if the middle linebacker scraped one side to another, like trying to fill a hole, that their defensive tackles didn't gap the holes. So there was a cutback in the middle. That was the key. So I'm on the sidelines, and all of a sudden they go, oh, okay, they put me in. Take Franco off, and they put me in. And at fullback.
Blazing speed.
And so it was basically 15 lead off to the left-hand side. and I, as a fullback, but my eye was right on the middle linebacker. He comes to try to stuff it into the five hole over there. I cut back, everybody's up on the line, and I got a step. And that's all I needed.
Beautiful.
It's a step ball.
71 yards later, right, touchdown.
Touchdown, that was it. You know, it would have been great if, but, I mean, it would have been great if, but Franco had won a touchdown. His won 77 yards. you know, and so I think running wise, we had gained 300 and some yards rushing that afternoon. So we kind of got lost in a bit, but in my mind, it was one of the best touchdowns. That one.
And what about this other one? Something that looks on the photos like this. A Rocky Blieler jumps 12 feet in the air.
Go a little higher than that.
A Super Bowl or something?
Yeah, it was the Super Bowl a little higher than that. Just give you some credit. It was like 18 feet. But anyway, I won't correct you on that. And so it was, yeah, so it was right before the half. The score was tied, as they recall. And the play was actually turned out to be a broken play, but it was a slant pass to me going right down the line of scrimmage. But they get all screwed up, and so I'm in the end zone, and Bradshaw now floating around there, and he sees me, and he throws the ball. I think he's thrown it away. I'm not going to let that happen. I jump as high as I can, as I say, 16, 17, 18 feet.
Yes.
Anyway, thunk, it stuck. Boy, was I surprised. But it came down, and we scored. And it gave us the lead, and as I like to tell people, the lead that we never relinquished thereafter, thank you very much, and ultimately won that game. But more importantly, it made the cover of Sports Illustrated.
Sports Illustrated.
Thank you very much.
I love you, brother.
See ya.
See ya.